First things first, I'm the realest.
Realest.
Drop this and let the whole world feel it.
Let them feel it.
And I'm still in the murder business. I can hold you down like I'm giving lessons in physics.
Right, right.
You should want a bad bitch like this.
Huh?
Drop it low and pick it up just like this.
Yeah.
Cup of Ace, cup of Goose, cup of Chris. I heal something worth a half a ticket on my wrist.
Back. On my wrist.
Taking all the liquor straight. Never chase that.
Never.
Top like we bring an 88 back.
What?
Bring the hooks in where the bass at. Champagne spilling, you should taste that.
I'm so fancy. You already know I'm in the fast lane. From LA to Tokyo. I'm so fancy. Can't you taste this gold? Remember my name. Hot to blow.
I said, baby, I do this. I thought that you knew this. Can't stand no haters and honest. The truth is that my flow, that my fit, HBD departed. I'm stupid, I can't shop in no department again.
Hi guys, I'm Ainsley. I'm here with Portnir for To The Point.
Yeah.
We're just going to cover a few topics today, and we'll start off with the Blue Wednesdays.
Yeah, if you haven't heard, we are supporting Mr. Cope, who is still battling cancer and fighting strong, and to be here with us for our Building Trades program. So if you're interested in a Cope's Crew shirt, it's pretty cool. You can buy those through the Counseling Center for $15. We need those by the end of the day Tuesday. And then if you don't want to buy a shirt, that's okay. Completely understand. Just wear blue on Wednesdays. And that just if you want to show your support.
Alrighty. So be sure to wear blue and get those shirts if you want one. Another topic, how about dress code and how we're reinforcing this year?
So it's not just this year. I reinforce it every year when spring rolls around, because we tend to forget what that dress code states. And so I'm just reinforcing it through announcements. And it's in the handbook. If you want to find it, you can go find it. But it's just a matter of making sure you're not a disruption to the learning atmosphere, but also you signed the code of conduct saying that you would follow those policies and procedures in our handbook. And that includes, you know, no crop tops, no skin showing at the waist. Shorts are mid thigh, I think is what it says. That one's one that's kind of, but the shirts are a big one. And then inappropriate messages. So right. make sure that you're keeping up with that.
Okay. Alrighty. Yeah, be sure. Because spring's coming, although it's hot, you know, you want to wear the tank tops and everything. You got to be good with that.
On that note, though, if you aren't dressed appropriately and a teacher says something to you, all you have to do is put on a t-shirt, change your clothes, and it's not even a write-up the first time. It's just a warning. But if you're reminded more than once, then it becomes a discipline thing.
All right. Okay. That should be easy enough.
Yeah.
Okay, next topic. How about a little bit of prom? I've heard that there's been things going on and making decisions for stuff like that.
Yeah, super excited that we get to have a prom this year.
I
know that the juniors and seniors are excited about that. Something that's a little bit different this year is that if juniors were unable to work the concession stand because of the shortened schedules, because of the shortened home games, just because of COVID, it's related stuff in general, you can purchase a prom ticket or work on the prom committee. And to take place of those points for your concession stand points. Those tickets are going to be available the same time as out of class dates forms are available, which is about 2 weeks before prom, and they're going to be $20 a junior. So if you didn't, and you only have to purchase a ticket if you didn't get your points.
Right.
Uh-huh. And also a little bit different, I said out of class dates because it's important that we kind of get an accurate number. We do out of school dates, but also this year, if you're going to bring a freshman or sophomore to prom with you, you're going to need to fill out one of those forms so that we have their name on the list.
Okay. And then the last topic that we have today is spring sports and possible student sections.
Yes, I'm so excited. Spring sports are outside, and things have kind of changed a little bit in that manner. The MEC guidelines for our spring sports have been changed. We are allowing students to come to our spring sports. Ainsley asked immediately, a student section? And I was like, not exactly a student section. You can come, you can be present, wear a mask. You have to have a mask, even though we're outside. Try to stay socially distanced as much as possible. But come support our teams. We have tennis, we have soccer, we have baseball, we have, who am I forgetting? Golf, which isn't really a spectator sport. But we have all of those things that we can actually kind of get involved with in the spring. So we're excited for that.
I'm glad that we're actually having spring sports this year. We're finally, be sure to come to soccer. There'll be a lot of stuff going on. And I bet all the teams would love to have you guys come and cheer for us. So yeah, thank you for coming and explaining stuff. All right, bye guys. Thanks guys.
Okay, I'm here with Mr. Carson Mead.
Hello,
Carson Mead.
How are you today?
I'm good. So I heard you're in Quiz Bowl.
I am indeed in Quiz Bowl.
How is your season?
We've been doing all right. It's been a little odd with the format this year being all on Zoom, but we haven't placed lower than 10th, I think, this year, so not too bad.
That's pretty good. So I heard you won conference again. How many years in a row is that?
I think it's the 22nd year in a row, 22nd, 23rd, somewhere around there. So.
22nd. Wow, that's a lot of times.
It's about 23 years.
That's crazy.
you might be honest.
Yeah, 22 is 23, right?
Yeah exactly. Sure I can. What's stopping me? That's what I thought.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a question.
Come.
And since you're in Quiz Bowl, you have to get it right.
Come. I'll try.
Okay, so we got to think of a question.
Oh, I have one. Yeah. Did you join Quiz Bowl on purpose?
No. Actually, no, I did not.
He didn't. I've been in Quiz Bowl since fourth grade, so yes, embarrassingly enough.
Okay, so. You can get back. You can get back to your chicken sandwich. Yeah,
thank you.
Okay, Wesley Darnell.
Wesley Darnell.
How excited were you when you heard Quiz Bowl won conference for the 23rd year in a row?
I didn't know that. It's pretty impressive. Yeah. Good job.
Spring sports, baby. Hey, Proc, what's coming up?
Apparently, spring sports are starting, and apparently, they're supposed to be good this year. And apparently, there's no restrictions, so you guys come watch us.
Oh my god!
This has been Tennis with Us.
Hi, I'm here with Mackenzie Reed, and can you tell us a little bit about speech and debate?
So basically, depending on what you do, we'll either do some competitive acting events or competitive debating. I personally do the competitive acting or interc, so I'll write a piece and make it my own, and we just kind of go to competition and compete against other schools.
Awesome. Are you going to nationals or districts or anything
State.
Like that?
State.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us like how you got there and what you did?
So basically I had to do a 10-minute recording of my piece that I cut and prepped and memorized and just submit it and go against the other people in the rounds, and I just qualified top two.
What piece did you do it over? Can you give us a little
Speak, which is a book. It's about sexual assault, and I raised a lot of awareness about it, and I did a personal monologue and narrative about it.
Oh wow, awesome. Thank you. I'm here with Aiden, and he's in speech and debate also. Can you tell us what's going on?
Well, currently, our most recent tournament that we did was districts for nationals, which decides who goes and competes at nationals. We got our results this morning, and me and my partner didn't make it past semifinals. We qualified last year, but sadly this year we didn't. So the plan for the future is just to keep working and hopefully we can qualify for another national tournament called NITOC.
Awesome, thank you.
No problem.
Okay, I'm here with Bryson and Emmeline, and they're in speech and debate. Can you tell us what's going on?
So we just had districts for state. We both do interp. I do the sad one.
And I do the funny one.
And I got second in district, so I qualified to state.
And I got fifth place in district, so I didn't make it to state, but I did a pretty good job this year.
Awesome, thank you guys.
Hello.
Hi guys.
Hey.
We are back with another drink review. We're gonna review Dr. Pepper because, contrary to what you might think, it tastes different.
It does.
We're starting up with Sonic because
Sonic's.
Their ice is so good. Solid. Tastes like a Dr. Pepper.
It is very carbonated.
I don't know. It's kind of good.
I feel like this is gonna be the same thing every time I drink it.
So, what do we rate it?
I give it a 7.
Seven, I guess.
Give us your personal.
No, I really don't know. It honestly just tastes like average Dr. Pepper.
I have a good
Sprite,
idea
Sprite.
For topics.
Sorry.
To talk about on my way.
Okay. What's the first?
But
we're currently parked.
But Briley, I don't know if you can really relate to it. I'm unbuckling.
Katie, no, you're not. Literally buckle up. You are in the middle. If I get into a car crash, you will die. You have more likely chance of dying over me and Briley.
I know.
You will literally go straight out the windshield wiper.
Oh,
windshield.
I like
windshield. Out the wipers.
Emily tried to tell us that you can't replace a breaker fluid.
Did you say breaker fluid?
Yeah, you did. I meant...
Y'all are so dumb.
I said windshield wiper because I thought that's what the whole,
but it was blinker. What's the topic?
Yeah. The fact that senioritis is...
Hey, let's not talk about that because I had a panic attack about that last night, Katie.
No. It's okay to, like, have senioritis.
To have panic attacks about it, guys.
No.
It's totally normal.
Well, saying that senioritis is, like, such this big thing, and obviously everyone has it right now. Honestly... Really, senioritis is just wanting to get out of here and start a new chapter because you're excited about your future. Why that's such a bad thing, I have no clue. But obviously, it's really hard to stay motivated, especially like when you're going to school with like freaking masks and all this crap. Like, yeah. I understand. But like, most of us are just excited to get out and start like a new chapter in our lives. You know? I just hate the whole negative outlook on it.
I think I just have, like, high school-itis.
Yeah, I get it. It's like, I don't know.
Alright, so we just went to McDonald's. I'm going to currently park in a curbside pickup place.
This one kind of tastes like TV static.
I hate this. First off, first complaint.
Ew.
What's the difference? This one's in a styrofoam cup. I don't care if they're worse for the environment. This feels disgusting in my hand. The bottom, fun fact, if you leave it sitting in your room for too long, it actually falls off and then your pop goes everywhere. So hate that.
Like one out of ten.
What is it called?
Syrup?
Flavoring? Yes, syrup. Oh, yeah.
It just tastes like,
I don't like something like this.
Like in your mouth.
Yeah. And like I can't swallow it because it like fizzles all the way down.
I think this is number one.
It tastes the same as all the
It literally just tastes like Dr. Pepper.
I think it's good.
Who is that? He kind of looks like Ben, like blonde
Ben Gold. Ben Gold.
Ben Gold James Bauer mix.
He looked back.
I feel like we did not do a good job.
I feel like we didn't.
London.
I think we're tired. It's a Monday. Bridges. And also we're reviewing Dr. Pepper and it all tastes the same.
It's falling down. So,
but McDonald's was the worst. Chick-fil-A was second. Sonic was first for me.
Yeah, I drank all my Sonic.
I think I agree.
Yeah. I like the Chick-fil-A one, but now the more I keep on drinking this one, I think I'm gonna agree with them.
Bye guys. Sorry.
Oh my god.
The runner-up and the rookie.
Lipstick, plastic, and paint, such a shame when they rise.